Hello everyone, and welcome back to another video on my Bionicle collection. It is 2019 now, so I thought I'd make a quick update. It's been almost 9 years since Generation 1 originally ended, so it feels like only yesterday really, but it really has been that long. So as far as my collection is concerned, it hasn't really, it has improved a little bit. I've got a few new ones that I'd like to show you, but the same sort of state as it is, or as it was last time with the display cabinets and the lights. So, first of all, I'll just show you the light function. I've got a little button over here where I can turn the lights on and off. I can adjust the brightness at two different levels, which is really cool. The great thing about having lights is just the colours of the sets comes off really nicely, and of course the glass doors prevent any dust from getting through, or at least minimise it as much as possible, so that the sets look in there nice and shiny really. So we'll start down at 2009, I think, is the sets on the lower shelf. I haven't actually got any, well I have, but not which would be displayed here. I haven't got any of the new 2009 sets, or any new 2009 sets. I'm still missing Metis and Zesk, and they're about the only ones I'm missing from this shelf, so not far off completion, really. Obviously, the top and the bottom shelves of the display cabinets don't have lights, because I just never bothered to fit them at the time. I didn't want to spend too much money, but yeah, so that's 2009. All the Glatorian Legends are there. It might be hard to see some of the ones in the back there, but yeah, only two Agori missing. And it's actually quite a shame I don't have lights on this shelf. I might add them in the future, but you know, with Atticus's blades, which glow in the dark, it would have been cool to have lights here, but never mind. So upper level, I've got 2004 here. I have all six Matoran. I think I was still missing two of them last time, but I've got all six now. And I still have all six Varki and only four of the six Termetru. I'll have to get around to picking up the last two eventually. I should also like to note for this shelf, each of these discs is the correct disc that the set originally came in. I believe each set, it wasn't like a random assortment. So for example, the only disc you could get with Nuri here is disc 143. And I believe I've got the correct disc for every set here. So everything's sort of perfect with that. And that's about it for 2004. Upper level, we've got 2007. This was my favourite year of Bionicle. Obviously, the Baraki and the Turmari are all there. I've got all 12 of them together. I think I mentioned last time I didn't bother putting a row of Matoran or Hydruka or whatever on the front here, because sort of 2007 Bionicle sets are starting to get quite big and take up a lot of room. I didn't want it to be too cramped, but it does look quite good as they are, I think. There's not really much else to say here. This centre shelf here is slightly taller than the other shelves, so I took it as an opportunity to put in some of my Titans. Here are some of the 2007 Titans. In the middle there, Nocturne, Hydraxon, Maxilos, Spinax, Gudunka, and then Karzani. So they do look quite good together, I think. Upper level, I've got 2008. I'm still missing quite a few sets from this year, I think. I'm still missing Solek and Photok from the front there, and Kirop and Radiak, the Shadow Matoran. I'm missing Bittle as well. I've got all six Toa from that year. I'm still missing Bittle. I've only got five of the Makuta. Although you will see I've got Mutran and Vikan in there. They're basically there just because I've got nowhere else to put them. It's sort of one of those things. I didn't want to put them elsewhere because they'd get dusty. But I don't have Bittl, so I've got a good space for them there. When I do get Bittl and when I get the other Shadow Matoran that I'm missing, I will probably probably put them in there and move Mootran and Vikan elsewhere. But there we go, 2008, looking quite good. And finally, at the top of this shelf at least, I've got 2005. We've got all six Vizrak and three of the Turhordika. This shelf is looking really incomplete. It probably won't even look complete when it is complete, because the only sets I'm having here are the Vizrak, which are very low profile, and the Turhordika, of which I have only three at the moment. I'm not going to bother putting the Rahaga in this one, because the Vizrak are the biggest pain in the ass to display. They take up so much room horizontally, but because they're not very tall vertically, they don't look like much, and having them on this top shelf, there's not a lot to look at, and of course there are no lights here either, but they still look, you know, cool nonetheless. I think I mentioned before, I really like the colours that the Vizrak have, but it's a shame just because of their shape, I'm not able to display them all. I imagine the best way you could do is by like attaching them to the wall, but I'm not going to do that. So there we are. There's the first cabinet. I think it looks quite good, especially from a distance with them all together, all the colours. It's really cool. So I'm going to move on to the second cabinet to show you what's in there. So there we are, close the doors. And here's the second one. Now down the bottom, there isn't actually really anything interesting going on. In my last video, I think I just had the Manas and the Tarakava in here. And I just wanted to put the Manas in one shelf because they are, first of all, they're quite uncommon, and second of all, they're remote control, so I wanted to protect them as much as possible. Tarakava only in there because there was some free space at the sides. You'll also see I've got three Turhanika in there as well. These are my first Turhanika. I was never a big fan of the Turhanika. I thought they were kind of mediocre sets, but I ended up getting them anyway. And I had nowhere to put them. It's a case of I buy before I have a place to put them. So I just this was probably the best place to put these sets. And so yeah, that's what I did. Turhanika and some 2001 Rahi in the same shelf. It's completely inconsistent, but there we are. Oh yeah, and all of the lights work as well on the swords, the laser swords that they carry. So should say that as well. But upper level, it's a bit more exciting. This is my 2001 shelf. We've got the 6 Turmata, the 6 Turaga, which I picked up recently. The Exetoa is from 2002 in the back there. It's another case of I had nowhere else to put him. I think he looks quite good there, though, even though this is a 2001 shelf, because each of the Toa did end up using an Exetoa in 2002. So I think it makes sense to have him on here. And at the front there, you'll see some of the masks I've got. I haven't got all of them. In fact, I've got a lot of duplicates of these particular masks. So I don't have any cow-cows, gold or silver cow-cows. I'm missing a few silver masks, a few gold masks. But eventually, when I get them all, they will go at the front here. But there we are. Upper level again. This isn't the 2002 shelf, this is the Bolrock shelf, because the Bolrock cow, I believe, were released in 2003, so you can't really say it's from 2002. This is just where I keep all the Bolrock and the Bolrock Var. I've got three Bolrock cow at the back there, and then all six Bolrock and all six Bolrock Var, all complete with their Krana, so it's all good there. Bolrock's a bunch of really cool sets, very popular. Definitely. Moving up a shelf, it's the center shelf again, so it's a bit taller. These are 2004 and 2005 Titans. 2004 Titans, 2005 Titans, they were all quite similar, so I thought it made sense to put them all on one shelf. Aesthetically, they are very similar with the sort of very sort of flat silver mechanical build. But they look really nice together, I think. I've got like Kitonga in the middle, then Rudaka and Sidrak at the sides, and then the opposite for the 2004 Titans. I think it looks quite good. Upper level, this is the Mask of Light collection, not the 2003 collection, because it's got the Turnover in there. I actually picked up quite a number of Turnover recently, that number being three. I got Liwa, Gally, and Kopaka. And then I already had all six Raakshi, and I already had all six Matoran from that year. It's just Toa Onua and Toa Pohati that I'm missing in their Nuva forms. And then this shelf would be complete. And then, as a little extension of the Mask of Light collection, it's probably quite hard to see up here. This is the Titan sets from 2003. You've got Takua and Puku there. Takanuva, Makuta, and Jala and Gokko. I also had made these little sort of stands for a few special masks from that year. It's quite hard to see, but the one to the left is the Kanoe Crocan. The one in the middle is the glittery version of the Avaki, and the one to the left, to the right even, is the Infected Howl, or one of the variants of it. I'm not sure which one. But yeah, just thought I had a spare Crocan, and I had this glittery Avaki. I thought I'd put them on display, and then I got that Infected Howl a little bit later. But yeah, unfortunately, no light on that shelf, so I couldn't light it up, which is a bit of a shame. But there we are, can't have everything. And so that is pretty much the second display case. I think it looks quite cool, but. These are just the sets which I have, which are in display cases. The rest of my sets are actually on open shelves. And obviously, I can't have a display case on every single shelf that I have. But I will say that the display cases are way better than the regular shelves. So, actually, the first set is down here. This is the Caxim V3 that I've got. It's a bit isolated, I must say, but I had nowhere else to put it really. The vehicle sets are really annoying to put anywhere because they're kind of like the Visorak. They take up a lot of room horizontally and not much vertically. But this shelf is a lot more interesting. Obviously, I've got the Exalera T9 here. I've basically this is the only shelf I can display the Exalera on, because it's so long and wide at the same time. So, I mean, even this is just the limit of what I can store with the Exalera T9. And then these guys are brand new. I'm really glad I picked these guys up for good prices. This is Vizon and Cardass on the left there, and Termatanui on the right there. I'm really glad I picked these guys up at for reasonable prices, because these guys are really uncommon. They go for a lot of money nowadays, so I'm pretty happy that I picked them up. And so this is the rest of the sets are sort of up the top here. So we've got Norik and Iruni there, the Tohaga. I think they're new as well. I think I saw them for a good price, so I just got them. The Jetrax T6, another vehicle set. In fact, all of these are vehicle sets. So you've got the Rocco T3 there, the Scorpio XV1, and the Baroness V7. They're all vehicle sets, so they take up a lot of room, unfortunately, but there we are. I suppose it's kind of cool seeing them in the corner overlooking everything. Now, the next section of my shelf is that I've actually added a new feature, and that is its own light. So there we are. I thought that was really cool. I've got like an LED strip running along the back there, which lights this entire shelf up. I thought that was really cool. So at the front here we've got Mazika, and actually I don't think I mentioned the front row here last time. We've got the two Hydruka from 2007, and the Matoran from 2007. So Sada, Idris, Dekar, and Deflak. And then the Boxer in there as well. The Titans I've got at the back there. We've got Ikarax, Bruteika, Voparak, and Tuma, and also Fearon Skirmix. And then off to the left here, we've got the Barrag Queens from 2002, Cardok and Gardok, the Muaka and Kane-Ra, the Nui Jaga. And then over here, I've actually got the Nui Rama, but between them, we've got Lesvik, Voltraz, and at the back there, you might be able to see, is the trap mechanism which came in the Karzani set. And another pain in the ass to display. And then over here to the left, we've got the Thornless V9 and the Sendox V1. And so that is pretty much my Bionicle collection. Most of it. I think it's quite good to have them in display cases. So the next thing I'm going to talk about is some of the instruction manuals and sort of pieces of memorabilia which I've got from Bionicle. So for this next part of the video, I wanted to show off some of the memorabilia and Bionicle instructions and things that I've got. I keep them in these large folders, full of sort of posters, Bionicle stuff. I have four large folders. The first one is just from 2001 to 2002, I believe. So we've got just posters. I've got three of these posters which came with the 2001 Termata sets, and they're on like they're in these little plastic wallets. I think this is a really ingenious way to store instructions and things. It keeps them all in good condition. This is a page full of instruction booklets, so for the Termata, I have to sort of change it there because otherwise they'll fall out the top. But there we are. We've got the Nui Rama here, which are really cool. They come in two separate instruction booklets. The Nui Jaga. It's interesting, I believe one of the instruction booklets didn't even have a back page, proper back page cover on that. But we've got some Tarakava here. Muaka and Kane-Ra. It's actually quite cool looking at the back page, which has all sorts of adverts from that year, being 2001. It's quite cool to look at. I really like this one. It's got like a storyboard on the back there. This here was just I think a piece of advertisement that I got in one of the sets. It's the only Bionicle related thing is this here, but it's still cool nonetheless. This page here has a bunch of these 2002 Krana packs, which came with a silver and gold Kanoe and three Krana, and they've got like different colours on their eyes, which is really cool. And this is 2002, so we've got Bulrock Var and Bulrock related things. We've got here two little comic booklets, one of the Bulrock and the second one of the Terra Nova. So here are the instructions for the Bulrock. If I can turn it over without them falling out. So more Bulrock here. Being six instruction booklets for each wave, I tend to keep four in one and two in the second one. Just to sort of spread it out, because the more you have in one plastic wallet, the higher the chance of it falling out. But for example, the Terra Nova here, I only have four of the Terra Nova, so they can just all go in one plastic wallet. We've got the two variants of the Boxer here, the Canon one and the non-Canon one. So that's cool. The Exotoa, we're coming to the end here actually. And the other variant of the Exotoa, which is the non-Canon one. And then Cardock. And finally, Gardock. So that's the first folder that I've got. I'll move on to the second one, which is from 2003 to 2004. So it's a bit weird. I haven't done it. For example, you'd think it would be 2001 to 2003, but I haven't done it like that because they can each of these folders can only hold about two generations of sets, give or take, really. 2003, of course, starts off with the Rakshi. I've got this poster here. I've got a comic for the Rakshi here. We've got some of the instructions for the Matoran of that year. We've got this Borat Cal comic here and some of the Borat Cal instructions. I have no idea what happened to my instructions for Korat Cal. It seems to be missing. It must be hidden away somewhere. When I buy my sets, I generally make sure they have box and instructions. And I've got instructions for about 85% of the sets and boxes for about 80%, 75%. I make sure to keep them all in reasonable condition, and of course with the instructions here. We've got some of the Rakshi here as well. Two of my Rakshi instructions, Lirak and Gurak, which are in between. They're in this plastic wallet, hidden in between. They don't have the front cover, so I'm going to need to go and pick up some better quality copy of those instructions. We've got Jala and Gucko here. And these are all the sort of 2003 Titan sets here. And then we're on to 2004. So I obviously with each of these instructions for the 04 Matoran, they come on the back with these big posters of combiners. Here are some, there's a Metronui comic there and some Kanoka cards, both for Nurak. We've got the instructions for the Toa Metru here. Again, I've only got four Toa Metru. Then we've got the Varki. So it's just kind of cool looking at all the art Bionicle. Really, these are just big art folders. Bionicle art folders. Oh yeah, the reason I've got Nurak twice in there is because I have two Nurak instruction booklets. So there has to put them. And the same with these guys. Because Voprak, nope, not Voprak, I think it's Ultimate Duma, comes with an extra copy of each instruction. And speaking of Ultimate Duma, I've actually got him over here. So if you're wondering where he went, there he is. Just on my shelf there. His wings make it too big to store on any other shelf. With his wings outstretched, he's taller than Termasanui, so it's quite difficult to find places to store these guys. And then we're coming to the end, Taraga Duma and Nivork. So the next folder, in fact, I'll put it away properly here. Next folder should be 2005 to 2007, and the reason that is the case is because I don't have many 2006 sets, so they don't take up a lot of room. But I might need to reorganize my folder when I do start to pick up on 2006 sets. So as you can see, the Visorak here. We've got the Tur Hordika. I've only got three Tur Hordika, so it's another case of only one page for them. We've got the Tur Haga. And then some of the Titans. I've got, again, with the Voporat case, where I've got an extra pair for each of the regular Titan. And then this booklet is exclusive to the Voporat combiner. So it's quite cool that I have that. And then I've got these little dividers. This is 2006. I've got Jala, Kongu and Harley, as you saw earlier in the video. And then just Brutaker. And then, again, like with Voporak, Vizon and Cardass came with exclusively printed instructions. So you've got one with literally just Vizon on there, which is really thin. And then one with Cardass on there, which is really thick. So that's cool. I always think with 2007, they did the best artwork. I really love the underwater theme they used for 2007, especially with the artwork. The Baraki, I don't have all the instructions for because I think I picked up Elek and he didn't come with instructions. So I'll probably need to get another version of him with instructions. Tomari, I never picked up. Well, I did pick up the instructions, but this was ages ago, and since I've lost a few of them, I've only got Nuparus, Hukis, Matoros with a tear on the front, and then Harleys without the front cover. So I'll probably need to get them again. We've got Lesvik here. This is all the Titans now. We've got Gdunka. We've got Hydraxon here. And then Maxilos and Spinax. And finally, Karzani. So that's the third folder. The final folder, which I will show next, will be for 2008 to 2010, although I don't have any 2010 sets, so there won't be any 2010 instructions on here. Although when I do get some 2010 wave sets, they will be in here. Or I might just have another folder for them, who knows. This is 2008, of course. We've got the Fantoka theme, which I kept being the first wave of 2008. And then the Mystica afterwards. And then we've got, remember I don't have Bittil, so we've got a missing one there. Icarax here, and on the back Mutran and Vikan. We've got Voltraz, Mazika, various instructions for the vehicles. This is going to be quite a few actually, because each of them came with three, I believe. So the Jetrax, the Xalar T9. And then we move on to 2009. We've got the Gori and the Glutorian, of course. You can't forget Glutorian Legends as well. I think I'm missing a few instructions here as well, even though I've got all the sets. Like, I don't know what happened to... I don't know what happened to Keener's instructions. This just seems to have disappeared. And yeah, they are. So it falls out really easily if you're not holding it properly. It's fairly easy to put back in. We've got Fear and Skirmix, Tuma, Tuamatanui. And I think... Oh no, we've got some sets after this. So the Sendox V1. This is actually missing its front cover, unfortunately. Caxium V3, Baroness V7, Thornus V9 is missing its front cover of its first booklet, but I've got the cover of the second booklet, as you can see. And then Scopio XV1. So yeah, that was just a quick video of my instruction booklets. So now I'm going to go on to the collectibles. So just to finish up, I just wanted to show my collectibles collection. It's not really a lot to show, but I'm not going to tip it all out to show you each individual thing, but I keep all of them in this little box. I've got all sorts of things in there. Krana. I've got 7 Shadow Krata, which came in the 500-piece collectible tub. And various stuff like Kanoka discs and Rotuka spinners. And I keep all the spare ripcords in there for the Rotuka spinners from 2005. Also spare ammunition and things like that. But as I say, I'm not going to bother showing you all of this. There we are. The other thing I want to show is where I keep the rubber bands that I've got. This is all like mostly the black rubber bands from 2001. Because these things, if you don't keep them in a sort of... If you don't keep it in good condition, then they dry out and they crack and eventually they'll break as well. So I wanted to preserve them as best as I could. The same goes with the yellow 2005 elastic bands, which came with the Visorak. You want to try and keep them in good condition. They're different textures to the 2002 Boric elastic bands and the little white elastic bands used on other sets. So yeah, that's where I keep my my rubber bands. And then this thing here, I just wanted to show you some of the cards which I picked up in the past from the they're just booster pack things from the Quest for the Masks Bionicle game. I just keep them in this little box here. To be honest, not too interesting, but there we go. So yeah, that's my Bionicle collection. Hope you enjoyed.